I would like to say a few words about the case of my university, not only because I am proud of the campus, but because this is a problem of the public space at the space of the university. So, yes. A few words about history, only few. Our university is the University of Economics, because there's also Warsaw University, which has a lot of faculties. We are a small school, only 10,000 students plus 3,500 postgraduate students. So our campus is also not a big one, but we are the oldest economic university in Central and Eastern Europe, created in 1906. And you know, founding fathers wanted to build a campus, but it was possible after the First War and after the Polish-Bolshevian War. So in 1922, the one of the Polish architect, a few, three concretely architects, was invited to the competition, a very small one. And it was a vision of Jan Kościec-Witkiewicz, famous architect of the time. He prepared two visions. This is another one from 1923. But they have the same assumption of those complex. First of all, it was in a palace style with two guardhouses and a public space between them, a big main building with two wings, and small blocks of flat for the university teachers and also for assistants, etc. So what has been done? It was the first building created in 1925, the academic year 1926, was started there. So we can see the structure and facade. The next one was our library, created in 1927 to 1930, is the facade as well. They are very similar, the same cubage, the same arcade. You can see it. And the main building, the vision, next vision from 23, the big one. And from 24, it was shortened to show those existing building, A building, first building, and library from the left side. So the main building was created after the Second World War, when our university was nationalized and changed the name from Warsaw School of Economics to Central School of Planning and Statistics. We come back to our name in 1991, or maybe 90, I don't remember this, but never mind. So you see, this is our main building with interesting roof as well. So those buildings, those professor buildings, it is a new one. It was created just out of context, of historical context. It was created in between 78 to 84. And now it creates us a new chance because it should be demolished by us because materials used on that time, etc., suggested that it would be the best to put it out. So, what has been done, we can see here in this presentation. This is our library, those buildings, professor building, assistant buildings, first building, and main building is here. Our campus, this is an area on this way, parking space before the big side. This corner is empty, this one and this one. And it creates a potential for investment to develop the university. So, I say a few words about public space. So, the very popular definition says that social space that is open, accessible to all. So, how it's at the university? We can say, in my opinion, that we have four types of public space. This is internal, inside buildings, with one function, to teach people, and multifunction, the second one, and external. So in our university, I only want to show you those four categories. This is the first one, our A building with big auditorium to teach. We can say that this is only one functional auditorium, but it's not true because it's not only for students. There's also conferences, There are different meetings there, but generally it's, we can say, only one functional space, public space. Another example, this is an auditorium in main building, very interesting because this balcony is hanging on the wall with interesting windows. But there are also multifunctional spaces there, like for example stairs. There are stairs like a foyer in the theater in our building, the first one built in 1925 and 6. The stairs at the library. Also, you can see an exhibition on the stairs on the left side. Very interesting structures as well. So, the reading room. Well, this, I would like to invite you to visit our school, by the way. So, there are only examples of those interesting spaces, but all of them create a special atmosphere of the university and create a historical context in which we try to rebuild something. Oh, this is a view to the library from inside, outside to inside. You can see those columns, etc., etc. This is the roof in the main building, where we can organize, we can say this is a multifunctional space. We can organize some different meetings here. And we can say every day there are a lot of students, some events prepared from their side, students, union, students, special scientifics, etc., etc. So there are only an examples how we can organize the multifunctional place. Or we can say, with the architect prepare space, as John said, we can create place. So, external. External, this is the internal garden. I suppose that our architect didn't think that it should look like this. Because, not because on the time when he planned it, there was no so many cars, but generally I think that his idea should be different. Because internal garden, this is about 1 hectare, it can offer us something more than only a place to park cars. And so, this is the internal garden among those buildings, and it creates a new challenge for us as well, but it's not the only one. So, the most important public space, external public space, before the main building, before this building, and from the other side. So, may I finish? Or you should I stop according to your request?
You may finish few more slides, but not all of them.
Okay. So what is the challenge? The challenge is that we should build something, especially because we lost this white building. And how our idea is growing up every day, grows up every day, I will show you after the break, according to Michel's disposition or order. Thank you very much for the moment.